Page 7.
Page 7 of the book. Continuing.
The next section, inshallah, is the subject matter of magic,
sorcery,
astrology, and fortune telling.
Sorcery, magic, astrology, and fortune telling.
This is the next section. Sorcery, magic, astrology, and fortune telling. What is the ruling of these things in Islam? So again, sorcery, magic, astrology, and fortune telling. Inshallah, we're going to see what Allah says, or what is the ruling in Islam with regards to these issues. Inshallah. In chapter 4, verse 51, Allah states, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Have you not seen those who were given a portion of the scripture? Have you not seen those who were given a portion of the scripture? They believe in jipt and tagut and say to the disbelievers that they are better guided in the right way than the believers. Have you not seen those who have been given a portion of the scripture? Meaning they know the truth. They believe in jipt and tagut. We talked about tagut already, right? And they say to the disbelievers, and they say to the believers that they are better guided in the right way than the believers. So there are some who claim that they believe, or they have scripture, or they follow scripture, or they have knowledge of the scripture, but Allah says that they believe in jipt and tagut in the process. They mix it. Ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu, who said, Ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu, who was the son of Umar, radiallahu anhu, he said, Al-Jipt means sorcery and magic, and Tagut is Shaytan. And Tagut is Shaytan. So they say that they have scripture. They know about La ilaha illallah. They know about the Quran. They know about the Old Testament. They know about the New Testament. They know about the Quran. But Allah says they mix it with Jipt and Tagut. They still believe in these things. They still want to do magic. They still want to do sorcery. And they still believe in Shaytan. They still follow Shaytan. You say that you're a Muslim, but you're still following Shaytan. You have become a Shaytan. You have become a Shayateen. You are a helper and advocate of Shaytan. Tagut is what? Anything that transgresses the bounds. We still believe in those who are transgressing the bounds. We say that we're Muslim, but I just got to still keep listening to Beyonce. I still got to keep listening to Rihanna or Ciara. Lil Wayne, I still got to do it. Waka Flocka, whoever is out there. Anybody who has transgressed the bounds. I'm just naming names that I know. It might be, I don't know who the new people is. Who's that gay dude? Wiz Khalifa. Huh? Y'all following him, dancing, wearing skinny jeans and all this other stuff. Right? You say we believe, but now we over here looking like Wiz Khalifa. Want to dress like Wiz Khalifa, wearing pink, want tattoos and their hair like his and all this other stuff. Looking like a homosexual. We cannot mix our Tauheed with Jahiliyyah. Chapter 2, verse 102. Chapter 2, verse 102. We talked about this ayat already. But being that we're in the subject matter of magic and sorcery and whatnot, we got to go over this ayat. So as you see, our dalil, we still use these same ayats over and over and over and over again. Although the Quran has 5,000 ayats in it, there's certain ayats that you can use over and over and over again that you have these main verses, you highlight these main verses, you highlight these main ayats, you have your dalil. I ain't got to know the whole Quran. I got to know this ayat, this ayat, this ayat. Oh, I want to deal with magic. Okay, chapter 2, verse 102. I want to deal with obeying the Prophet, obeying Allah, obeying the Sunnah, chapter 5, verse 59. I'm going to tell you about my purpose of life, 51, 56. I'm going to tell you that the jinn, Shaitan was a jinn, chapter 18, verse 50. Four ayats, real quick, four different subjects that I could use just in four ayats and go for a minute with my dalil. Okay? So chapter 2, verse 102. Allah states, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. But the Shayateen disbelieved, teaching men magic. So magic is a part of disbelief. Magic, you don't hear a lot of people talk about magic a lot on the minbars and kubbas. Allah talks about it a lot in the Quran, though, in the Hadith, about jinn. You don't hear a lot about jinn. You don't hear a lot about these things. People need to talk about these things because these things are real.
They're real.
But the Shayateen disbelieved teaching men magic and such things that came down to Babylon.
Y'all remember that? Y'all hear Babylon, y'all hearing in the songs, Babylon, y'all hearing in all these reggae songs, right? Babylon. So, what's so special about Babylon? Babylon is where magic was performed. They was doing magic in Babylon. Man, they was teaching magic. This is where magic was prevalent. It was going down in Babylon. Magic. Who knows where Babylon was at? Where was Babylon?
Egypt.
Where was Babylon? Don't guess, man. Where was Babylon at? If you don't know, I don't know. So you can know. You're going to know today, right? Ibn Mas'ud, he said, it is part of intelligence or wisdom that when you ask the question you don't know, you say you don't know. And that's a part of being wise. There's another proverb that says, fools rush in where wise men never go. A wise man knows that he knows not. It's better to stay quiet and be deemed as quiet than to open your mouth and remove all doubt. Stop guessing. You don't know? Say you don't know. All right? Babylon was in modern day Iraq. Iraq. Yeah. Babylon. So again, Babylon was in modern day Iraq. Y'all be hearing about Iraq right now? That's where Babylon was at. Start being familiar about your history and what was going on. Do you know who else was the king of Iraq or Babylon? Let's see if y'all know this one. Who was the king of Babylon? Who was one of the kings of Babylon? His name was Nimrod. Nimrod. Y'all know who Nimrod was? Nimrod was the son of Canaan. Nimrod was from the Ham lineage. Canaan had a son whose name was Nimrod. So it came from an African lineage, a Hamite lineage. So the people of Babylon that was doing magic got to tell the truth. And if you don't know, you won't know. But if you do know, now you know a little bit better. So for people, so we think that magic is only done by a certain type of people. Oh, white people will do that. No, no. Blacks was doing it too. Blacks was doing magic. In the time of Egypt and whatnot, they was worshiping the sun god and all of that. Them was black people. Let's tell the truth. We wasn't always doing, we was pyramids and, yeah, but all of that was shirk. Some say that they was able to do that because they was coordinating with the jinns. They was doing magic. That's how they was able to do the pyramids and whatnot. Some people say that. Because they can't even do that to this day to duplicate the pyramids. They can't. They said it was, they can't. And at that time, for it to be so precise and whatnot, they're like, man, how did they do it? So again, Babylon was in modern-day Iraq. If you watch the TV, if you've been watching TV, you guys have been hearing about ISIS and all this other stuff. They in Iraq right now. They cut off a lot of people's heads in Iraq because they did a major sweep and killed all the sorcerers and warlocks because they was doing a lot of magic in Iraq. They was finding all these manuscripts and books and volumes of magic books in Iraq, in Babylon. But if you understand the Hadith, you understand the ayats, man, that's where magic was. It was going down in Babylon in Iraq. So this was that culture. It was handed down over there. And they were showing the brothers, oh, they're killing them. They're cutting their heads off. Man, why? They got guilty. They got caught doing magic. They cut their head off. They head. The punishment for magic in Islam is death. Okay, continuing on this ayah. But the Shayateen disbelieved, teaching men magic and such things that came down to the people of Babylon. I just want to give y'all a little bit of history of Babylon. They learned from them, the Shayateen, the means to cause separation between the man and wife. We talked about that last week, that some people do magic to cause divorce. And they knew that the buyers of such magic will have no share in the happiness in the hereafter. So those who do magic, they'll be in the hellfire. Those who do magic will be in the hellfire. If you read the Tafsir, again, y'all go to Tafsir Ibn Kathir, and you look up this chapter and this verse, and you check out this ayat. It gives you long hadiths about when the people was teaching people magic, and it said that whenever they did magic, that the light of their Islam would be removed from them, and a darkness would be put over them. The light of belief would leave them, and a darkness like a cloud would come up over them when they were guilty of doing magic. Black magic. Okay? Magic is real. Even though you may not believe it, magic is real. You got people still doing magic.
right? Even with the girls, oh, I'm going to take his drawers or I'm going to put something in the spaghetti or I don't want him to go nowhere. Let me take a picture. Love potion number 9 and, you know, all of that. That's magic. Big Mama taught me this little secret that if you want to keep him, do this. That's magic. We may take it lightly. Oh, that's just an old trick. No, that's an old magic trick. All right. Thus, we should know that all forms of magic are haram and will have one in the hellfire for indulging in magic. Ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhu, one of the Sahabas, he says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever draws knowledge from the stars, whoever draws knowledge from the stars, meaning horoscopes, has committed sorcery and magic. So anyone who draws knowledge from the stars, meaning the falling star, jinns, so forth and so on, they have committed magic. We must understand that anything dealing with magic is dealing with the jinns. Anything dealing with magic, you are dealing with jinns. You're doing magic to get some type of power, or you're doing magic to acquire something. You are seeking izza. You're seeking power from jinns, from other entities other than Allah. Man, I just want to, you know, sell your soul to the devil, man. Give him 3 wishes, and I dream a genie, and the genie in the lamp, and all the jinns, shaitan, magic, sell your soul, go to hell, right? They done made it into a movie. They done made it into a TV show. I remember growing up, I dream a genie. I used to watch that all the time, because I wanted a genie. Hi, master. I'm like, shoot, I want one of them. I'm looking for my bottle. I'm not trying to find me a bottle of genie in a bottle, man. I'm trying to find me a bottle so I can find me a genie. So I can make 3 wishes. They make movies about it and everything. The genie, you know, y'all heard of Mac Dre? I'm the genie in the lamp. Yeah. He told you he was a genie. Had everybody on ecstasy pills. Had a whole generation of kids on ecstasy pills, popping dolphins and all kinds of stuff. I'm glad I was locked up at the audience. Man. Going crazy. They still thizzy to this day. Had a whole generation of people crazy. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Still, people still talk about Thizz Nation. Thizz is what they still talk about. Yada I mean. Yeah. Yada I mean. Yada I book book. All that stuff. But anyways, Mac Dre. Yada I mean. It's a Bay thing. It's from the Bay. It's a Bay thing pertaining to coke and ecstasy. Yee! All that. Yeah. That. Yada I mean, yada, yeah, yada I mean. Like, you know what I mean? Instead of, you know what I mean? Yada I mean? We'll have these classes on another day. Yeah, we'll have game on Tuesday. But he called himself the genie in the lamp, okay? And it was a catchy song, but if you understand, like, whoa, I'm like, man, I'm like, this dude is calling himself a jinn. So I had to break it down. I'm like, man, he called himself a jinn, and he was a pimp. And he had a whole generation of people hypnotized trying to be like him. I'm like, oh, Shaitan is cold. Had a whole generation of people talking like him, want to dress like him. He had everybody wearing dreads. Mac Dre. Shaitan has people that are Shayateen. He uses certain people to mislead the people. And he uses the music. The music industry is very big on leading people astray. Lil Wayne. It's a Shaitan. That dude is a tall boots. I keep saying it. He called himself Allah. He's in the music. You got Jay-Z. Called himself Jehovah or Jehovah. Kanye. All these dudes, they the son of God. And Nas called himself the son of God. And man, we sitting here listening to it. Yeah. Man, okay, he called himself son of God. He called himself Jehovah. This one called himself Allah. This one, he calls himself the rap god. She calls herself a diva, and diva means goddess. And we sitting here buying their records and cashing them out, listening to it, bumping it, liking it. Again, back to here, it says, but most of them say they believe, but yet they mix it with Tagut and they mix it with Jip. They believe in these things too, though. Music is magic. There are certain instruments that call the jinn. This is all in Hadith. Flute instruments, anything that's wind or string instruments, it calls the jinn. That's why music is haram. The trumpet calls the jinn. The violin calls the jinn. The harp calls the jinn. The guitar.
The drums. drums?
No, not the drums. Wind and string instruments. Wind, anything that wind, you blow the wind in it, clarinet, trumpet, horn, right? Strings, guitar, use a lot of rock and roll. They call a lot of gin. Devil worship. Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, he reported that the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, whoever goes to an astrologer, right? Fortune teller, horoscope. Whoever goes to an astrologer, a fortune teller, or a priest and believes what he tells him, has committed shirk and has denied what was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whoever goes to an astrologer, someone who is the art of horoscope telling, or a fortune teller, or come to me, or a priest, and priest Cleo, right? You call somebody on the phone, they tell you something. Well, this is going to happen to you. And he said, if you believe what they tell you, you have committed shirk. You read a horoscope in a like we used to do back in the day, go to the newspaper and look for your horoscope. Today you're going to do this, or today, or the fortune cookies. If you believe in this horoscope, we've committed shirk. Because now we're saying that this person, whoever came up with this saying, that's telling you what's going to happen to you in tomorrow, that they have power other than Allah. Allah says Allah is the only one that knows what's going to happen in tomorrow. So it is shirk.